Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I am talking about measurement, geometry, area and perimeter and circumference for different figures that you might have in your final exam for Math 90. So in the first picture here, we're asking you to find the perimeter and area for an odd shape. So if we look at the bottom here is 11. And if I do this, do a dotted line down on both of these, I can see that this was 4 and this was 2. That's 6. And since the whole side has to be 11, then I know that this must be 5 meters there. And this is the same depth here, so that's meters, 4 meters also. And then side to side, I have the same, so that's 10 meters. Once I have all the sides listed, I just add those up for the perimeter. So starting here, I'm going to start here at this corner. I'm going to put a little star to remind myself that's where I started. I'm going to say 4 plus 4 is 8, plus 5 is 13, plus 4 is 17, plus 2 is 19, 29, 39, 40, 50, 39, let me start over. So hopefully you'll be a little smarter about it. Okay, 8 and 5 is 13 and 4 is 17, 18, 19, 29, 30, 40, 50. Yep, I think I got a little bit spaced out there, but I think it's 50 meters. You just add all the sides to find the perimeter. To find the area, what we're going to do is find the area of the separate blocks and then add those together. So this first block is 4 by 10, so you're going to do 10 times 4, or 40. What's the area of this? Well, this was 4, this whole thing was 10, so this must be 6. So I have 6 times 5, which is 30, and then over here I have 2 times 10, which is 20. So my area is the sum of those three parts, 40, 30, and 20, which is 90, and of course when you're talking about area, you have to have square units, because you're saying how many of these little squares are there inside this whole thing. And we could actually count the little squares and get 90, or we can do it the way we did it. 10 by 4, a 5 by 6, and a 2 by 10, and we got that total. What about the, so the area is length times width for a rectangle. So over here we have a circle. The circumference formula is diameter times pi, and the area formula is pi times radius to the second power. So when we have a 12-inch diameter, then what's the radius? Well, the radius is half of that, so the radius is 6. So those are all the two numbers that I need to know. And then for our purposes, when we approximate, we're going to use pi as 3.14. If we want the exact, we would leave the pi just as the symbol pi, because I should show the approximation symbols. Once you change pi into 3.14, you're approximating, because it's not exactly 3.14. So approximate for the circumference, or the approximate for the circumference, is the diameter times 3.14. That's just a linear distance around the circle, so we don't have square units there. I'm just going to give it, as I see it, 37.68. If I asked you for exact on this, the exact circumference is 12 pi, because that I haven't approximated pi. I'm leaving it as 12 pi. The approximate is the 37. The exact would be 12 pi. Approximate the area. For the area, we have pi r squared, so 3.14 times 6 to the second power, and that is 3.14 times 36, which is 100, and this is the approximate, I should give you the approximate symbol, 113.04. What are the units here? This was yards, and area always is to the second power, whatever your unit is. Now the exact for this one would be 6 squared, which is 36, times pi, but instead of approximating, we would just put that in. So we don't substitute in the 3.14 for the exact. So exact would be 36 pi, approximate would be 113.04. This is still yards squared, though. All right, so for the perimeter and area of this is a trapezoid. So for the perimeter, we just add up the sides. We have, I like to put a little start, so I remember where I started. 5 and 6 is 11, plus 5 more is 16, plus 10 is 26 centimeters. What's the area formula? The area is you have to find the average of the two bases, multiply it times the height. So you have big base plus little base divided by 2 times the height. That's a way to think about it. You can sometimes see that area as written as this. But we know that half, time easing by half, dividing by 2 is the same thing. So what do we have? We have our big base plus our little base divided by 2, and then times that, the height times 4. So we have 16 divided by 2 is 8 times 4, or 32, and it's an area, so it's centimeters squared. Perimeter and area. All right, what about the... okay, so we'll do that one in a second. What about the perimeter and area for a parallelogram? Well, the area is base times height. So we have 9 times 7, which is 63, but we have feet squared. The perimeter, you just add up all the sides, remembering that opposite sides are congruent. Whoops, that's not base times height. That was a mistake. Sometimes I try to finish, I'm looking at the time, and I gotta hurry, and then I make mistakes. And you know, when you're, it was off screen anyway, I should never have showed you. When you're doing your math, same thing. You need to have time and to think about it, and don't rush, or you make mistakes. What am I actually multiplying there? 7 is the base, but 9 is not the height. The height is the dotted line here, which is 5.5. So I need to multiply base times height, which is 7 times 5.5. What is 5.5 as an improper fraction? 2 times 5 is 10, plus 1 is 11. And I can make 7 over 1. So when I multiply across, I get 77 over 2, and that is feet squared. Now, depending on what they ask for, when you put it into the computer, they might ask you for the answer in a decimal form, and that would be 38.5 square feet. Let me let that dry a little bit. The perimeter we can do starting here, 9 and 7 is 16, and then 16 and 16 is 32. So we have 32 feet. That, remember, the perimeter is linear, so we don't put any squares on that. And then over here, we did base, which was 7, times height. 5.5 is the same as 11.5. And then that, I said, was 38.5. And that's always square feet. It's also, you could say 38.5, or 77.5 would be fine with me. The other thing, couple things that I want to show you briefly on here, if you want to find the volume of a rectangular prism, you multiply length times width times height, and so we have 5 times 3 times 4, which is 60, but what's the unit? Well, it's to three-dimensional, so it's centimeters to the third power. So remember, volume is always to the third power because you're talking about something three-dimensional. Over here, the area in square inches, it's given in inches, so I would say 11 times 5, which that was kind of a low top. 11 times 5, which is 55 inches squared. But when you think about converting to square feet, you have to be careful. Let's say that this was a square foot right here. A square foot means I have 12 inches on this side, and I'd have 12 inches on this side. If I multiply 12 times 12, I'd actually have 144 inches squared, right? So if I want to convert 55 inches using unit conversions, I would say there's 144 square inches in every square foot. So it's actually 55 divided by 144, which I'm going to approximate to the nearest hundredth, is 0.38 square feet. So don't forget about square inches has a different conversion. So for my Math 90 classes, I have a list of charts and conversions that you're welcome to request before you take the final that has that kind of thing on it, plus all the area formulas that we've used. And the last thing that's on your test is finding the length of a missing side. This is a right triangle, so we use the Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So you take 11 squared plus 23 squared equals c squared. 11 squared plus 23 squared is 650. And then to find the c by itself, because you just want that, you take the square root of that. So you take the second power square root of 650. And that gives you, if they ask you to round to the nearest whatever, you might need to enter into your calculator a decimal point at the end of your number so that it actually gives you a decimal answer. If you don't enter the decimal point on some calculators, it just gives you the simplified radical form, which is nice, but if we want the decimal form, we can. If we want to round that to the nearest, let's say, tenths, that would be 25.5, would be the length of that missing side. Okay, that's it for your final exam, part B, and I hope you have a fantastic day.